the best carpal tunnel exercise in the world. It sounds like an exaggeration. Do we even really know what the carpal tunnel is? And how is the carpal tunnel affected by our daily habits? Carpal tunnel is a structure just proximal to where your wrist is. And what happens through that structure is you have 8 finger flexor tendons that pass through, as well as 1 thumb flexor tendon, as well as the median nerve. And in this structure, that median nerve becomes entrapped or affected by pressure. And that pressure on the median nerve causes problems in the hands, can cause pain, numbness, and weakness. And that's what we will call carpal tunnel syndrome. But we're focused on the carpal tunnel structure itself and how it actually breaks down. The carpal tunnel is an osteofibrous tunnel. Now, what does that mean? Well, osteo relates to bone, and fibrous refers to the ligament that forms the top of the tunnel. So the base of the tunnel is made by the wrist bones, and the side of the tunnel on the thumb side is made of the scaphoid bone and the trapezium. The pisiform bone and the hamate bone make the medial border of the tunnel, kind of on the pinky side. Across the top of the tunnel is the transverse carpal ligament. It is a very, very important structure. Okay, so how do our grip habits have any effect on the carpal tunnel? Well, the truth is they have a huge effect. And I don't know for the life of me why anybody hasn't really focused on this area. But of course, it's right in our backyard. We study grip, and we study all of the muscles of grip, and thus we run into this carpal tunnel breakdown all the time. So there are 9 muscles that close the hand. They are attached at the finger, thumb, hand, wrist, carpal tunnel, forearm, and elbow. And the same thing as there's 9 muscles that open the hand, they're on the back of the finger, thumb, hand, wrist, carpal tunnel, forearm, and elbow. So there is a balance between the 9 muscles that close and the 9 muscles that open, but somehow we've really forgotten about that. Now, specifically when it comes to the carpal tunnel, you have 4 small intrinsic muscles that actually originate on that transverse carpal ligament. And these are the pons muscle of the thumb and also the small flexor muscle of the thumb, as well as the pons muscle of the small finger and the flexor muscle of the small finger. Now you can even see, if I was pretending to hold, let's say a paintbrush is the example I use, you can see by holding a paintbrush or a small item, but that could be any kind of tool or it can be any grip motion with the fingers, you see right off the bat that where the carpal tunnel is literally breaks down. We can see that in front of our own eyes. Now if I painted for years and years and years, that would cause this carpal tunnel to collapse. And we have to watch the structure of the carpal tunnel. When that structure gets smaller or when pressure comes inside, that's what causes median nerve problems. Now on top of that, when I'm flexing something, not only do those attachments tighten of those small finger muscles, but remember we have 8 finger flexor tendons coming through. So if those flexor tendons are coming through, as well as the tightness on the top, we have multiple stressors at that carpal tunnel. So whoa, whoa, whoa on all the bad news. What can we do if we grip, and especially if we grip small items, and especially if we flex? What can we do to keep ourselves healthy? Well, that's what we came to discuss. Let's discuss the best carpal tunnel exercise in the world, and here we go. So now a little bit of good news. I've got our Handmaster Plus that we designed specifically to train grip muscles properly so that we can have healthy fingers, thumb, hand, wrist, carpal tunnel, forearm, and elbows. But let's talk specifically about the carpal tunnel here. What I'm going to do, I've got the Handmaster Plus on. I've got basically the thumb goes on the base of the thumb, and the fingers all go mid-knuckle. Once I have it loaded on, I am going to do the most simple but complete exercise possible. And we very dramatically name it the hand closed, hand open exercise. I'm gonna have the elbow supported against my rib cage. I'm gonna keep my wrist straight. I'm gonna squeeze against the ball for a count of 1. And then I'm gonna open and spread for a count of 1. So let's look as I open and spread. As we talked about, we gave you all the bad news on the flexor side, how the small muscles of the fingers will attach right on that transverse carpal ligament and have a tendency to collapse it. But the muscles on the back, the abductor and spreading muscles, are where the good news comes in. As I strengthen these muscles on the outside of the thumb and intrinsically in the hand, they will spread and keep that carpal tunnel trained nice and wide. So we oppose the muscle, we strengthen the opposing muscle groups, and that's how we can keep your carpal tunnel nice and strong and healthy. So again, close the ball for count of one, open and spread for count of one. And I just keep on doing that exercise until I feel a comfortable fatigue, and that is what's going to offset our daily repetitive gripping. And that's what keeps the carpal tunnel nice and stable, nice and healthy, with proper blood flow going through and going back away back to the heart. If you grip, you're going to have some breakdown of the carpal tunnel. This is such an easy way to offset it. In the old days, I had to show you three or four exercises that you would probably not remember, and you'd have all different elastic bands, balls, stuff laying all over the place, and you'd have to switch the position over and over on your fingers. Now, you put the Handmaster Plus on, you close against the ball, you open and spread against the cord. Nothing could be simpler. And now that you understand the imbalance that can break down the carpal tunnel, there's no excuses, an easy exercise to offset it. It's the best exercise you'll find because it's simple, it's complete, and it doesn't take a long time. You'll have an easy time with it. If you have any questions about anything you've seen in this video, please contact us at info@docsac.com. Or you can visit our website if you'd like to get your own Handmaster Plus. We'll show you where you can find it. You can see some of our distributors and partners, or you can buy online. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a lot about the carpal tunnel and about how to keep that carpal tunnel stable and healthy.
Handmaster Plus, number one for strength and balance. Fingers, hands, and thumbs. Gotta get your one, gotta get your one. Handmaster Plus. Speed and strength, your best performance. A sign of things to come. Gotta get your one, gotta get your one.